We've just come up here onto the reef platform on Browse Island, and this expansive place that we've come to see what else is living here. And of course, one of the risks that we have to be careful of while we're walking around is stonefish. And if we walk in here, we're lucky enough to have found one. This one's called a reef stonefish. It's not the same as the real stonefish, but almost as venomous and just as spectacular. If you have a look at this guy here, you'll struggle to see him unless you really get in close. And you can see he looks just like a stone. Has a little bit of algae growing all over him, and he's hiding there waiting for something to come past that he can eat. These guys have 13 venomous spines along their back, and if you see here, each one of these little spines is highly venomous. He has two little sacs of venom at the base of each one, and when you step down on it, it slides the sheath of skin down, and the venom is injected into you just like out of a hypodermic syringe. If you're unlucky enough to step on one of these things, you'll be dancing around in all sorts of pain and all sorts of agony. We can treat it, but it's going to last a long time, and there's not much you can do other than some warm water and hopefully and some painkillers and lots of rest. So he sits on the reef like this, and he's just waiting for something to come past, opens his mouth and creates a vacuum, sucks in a little fish that he can eat. But of course, while he's sitting here, he's highly vulnerable, and so he needs these incredibly venomous spines to act as protection. These guys are also really, really hardy. Living here on this intertidal reef platform, they spend an awful lot of time at low tide and, in fact, out of the water. They can spend like 24 hours out of the water and still survive. If they happen to be stuck up on a rock, they just wait, and eventually the tide comes back in and away they go.